I found one. It was a path that ran alongside her house. First, I was frightened. She never bothered me, so I kept going that way. The path went past the grave of her dog. One day, I stopped to put some wildflowers on its grassy surface. As I placed them, I heard a noise behind me. I straightened very quickly and whirled around to find her standing there, watching me. A pang of surprised anxiety shot to my heart. But it faded quickly when I saw the tears on her cheeks. We stood there looking at each other for a long time. Despite the tears, her eyes were clear, blue and clear. Her glance seemed to pass completely through me, and yet, somehow, it was soft. I opened my mouth to speak, but no words came, so I turned and ran down the path, not even looking back. I stayed at the fishing place all day. That evening, as I went home, passing her house, I saw her in the garden, reading. As I drew near, she looked up, and I caught just a suggestion of a nod of greeting. I waved my hand once, very slowly. She went back to her work. From then on, every day, the same thing happened. She nodded, I waved. Then one morning, when summer was almost gone, I didn't see her as I started for the fishing place. Her house was quiet. There was no sign of life. I thought it strange, but I supposed that she'd gone away on a trip somewhere. I knew I'd miss her, but there was still a lot of fishing to be done in the few remaining days of the season. So I walked on to the fishing place, being very quiet, so as not to disturb the sunfish. Cautiously, I crept to the edge of the bank and peered into the water. I saw a face looking up at me. It wasn't my reflection. It was her. She was dead. At first, I was shocked. Somehow, I wasn't afraid. She looked so peaceful and contented. A thin smile on her face, her eyes opened wide, looking at me and through me. And still soft, as if she were dreaming of some far-off land. For a long time, I just stood there, returning her gaze. Then I grew tired of standing, so I sat down. I don't know how much time passed before we talked. I spoke to her, and her reply seemed to just come into my mind, even though there was no sound from her lips. Her hair intrigued me. It swirled loosely about her head as the strands were caught in the tiny eddies. I asked her if she wanted to come out of the water. The answer came to me, why should she want to leave there? Wasn't it peaceful? Quiet? Wasn't she relaxed? And there were no people from the village there to laugh at her. She was happy in the water. I wanted her to be happy. I wanted her to be happy because she was kind. And she didn't yell at me like Mother sometimes did. And she answered all my questions. And she listened patiently to what I had to say without telling me that little boys were made to be seen and not heard. She listened. And occasionally, when the water moved, she nodded. Ever so slightly, but she nodded. She was agreeing with me and listening to me, and I loved her for it. I was sad at the thought of leaving her again. She said, why leave? Why not stay? It'll be easy. Just walk into the water. We can be together for always. Her words warmed me. I wanted to stay with her. I'd always wanted to stay with her. Why not? Why go back? She beckoned me. I started toward the water's edge. She was smiling brighter than ever. I felt good. No more parties, no more bad books, no more worry and confusion. Just as the sole of my shoe touched the water, sending tiny circles out into the reflection, I heard the car pull to a stop on the road. I turned momentarily and saw the lights go off, and then turned back to look at her. The tiny waves had reached the reflection and twisted it in 100 places. Her face was still there, but her expression had changed. The smile was evil. The eyes streaked with yellow were gleaming madly. I jerked back from the water's edge. I'd never seen her like this before. I picked up a heavy stone, and against all my desire, I threw it into the pool. She was gone. Broken completely. And then I turned, started walking toward the car. Walking from the river to the road.
...1956 was a banner year on Broadway. The season saw the openings of such musicals as Candide with the music of Leonard Bernstein, Bells Are Ringing starring Judy Holliday in one of her best roles, Frank Lesser's The Most Happy Fella, Little Abner, and the biggest hit of the generation, a show that ran for years and years, My Fair Lady. My Fair Lady contributed almost a dozen hit songs to AFN's ever-growing library of hits. Now, for the next few moments, let's listen to a few of them.
Does enchantment pour above every door? No, it's just on the street where you live. And oh, the towering feeling just to know.
Why can't the English teach their children how to speak? This verbal class distinction by now should be antique. If you spoke as she does, sir, instead of the way you do, why, you might be selling flowers, too.
I beg your pardon, sir.
Knight, old man, you did it. You did it. You did it. You said that you would do it, and indeed you did. I thought that you would rue it. I doubted you'd do it. But now I must admit it and succeed you did. You should get a medal or be even made a knight.
It was nothing. Really nothing.
All alone, you hurdled every obstacle in sight.
Now wait. Now wait. Give credit where it's due. A lot of the glory goes to you.
But you're the one who did it, who did it, who did it. As sturdy as Gibraltar, not a second did you falter. There's no doubt about it. You did it.
All I want is a room somewhere, far away from the cold night air, with one enormous chair. Lots of chocolate for me to eat, lots of cow like lots of ease.
I'm so used to hear her say good morning every day. Her joys, her woes, her highs, her lows are second nature to me now. Like breathing out, breathing in. I'm very grateful she's a woman and so easy to forget. Rather like a habit one can always break. And yet, I've grown accustomed to the trace of something in the air, accustomed to her face.
And now, from Broadway to Hollywood, where in 1956, movie soundtracks were fast becoming almost as expansive as the pictures themselves. And the Hollywood bosses were realizing just as fast that specific numbers from the soundtracks were potential sources of additional income. Many of these numbers became big hits as singles.
Anastasia, tell me who you are. Are you someone from another star? Anastasia, are you what you seem? Do your sad eyes remember a dream?
Time has come for me to say sayonara. My heart will always be yours for eternity. I know sometime we'd have to say sayonara and promise that you'll be returning someday to me.
Music from Three Motion Pictures, vintage 1956. Anastasia, Sayonara, and Around the World in 80 Days. Do you remember the ill-fated $64,000 question with its soundproof booth, second plateau, and Hal March? Well, the $64,000 question was probably the hottest TV show going in the States in 1956, and such popularity spawned dozens of parodies. One of the best that year, heard on AFN, was done by the comedy team of Reese and Davis.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome to your $64,000 question. And here, back for the fifth time, having already won $32,000, our race car driver, Speedy Murphy.
it's nice to be here.
Nice to have you.
Where'd he go?
Nice to have you back on our show. Here, we're on television.
Yeah, I know. My whole family's looking in.
Oh?
The whole Murphy family.
Oh, that's wonderful.
Can I say hello to my sister?
Okay.
Hello, Bridie? Boy, listen to that baby purr.
Yes, I know.
Here'd he go.
I suppose it's been a very exciting week for you.
Very exciting, very thrilling week.
Lots of letters and telegrams.
Telegrams? I got a telegram from my brother. I haven't heard from him in about 16 years.
Oh.
He's a race driver.
Oh? Yeah. What did he say?
Send money. Listen to that baby purr,
yes,
boy.
Yes. You have a very unusual occupation here.
Different.
Tell us a little more about it. Have you won many of these races?
Well, one time I drove from Chicago to New York and I was first.
Oh?
But I was disqualified.
Why?
I was supposed to go to L.A.
Of course.
See, there's a blinker light in Des Moines. It's confusing. Look out! Women drivers.
Yeah.
Road taker upper. Oh, yeah, that's a valve knock. I can fix that.
Yeah, let's get serious. I'm sure the entire country... I'm sure the entire country is waiting for your answer to this next question. Have you reached your decision?
Yes, I have, Mr. March.
May we have it, please?
Well, I definitely decided I'm going to go for the $64,000.
I admire your courage. Are you nervous?
No, I'm not nervous, no.
Why are you biting your nails?
I'm not biting my nails. I'm scratching my teeth.
Oh, I see. All right, sir. All right. Your category is geography.
Geography.
And it's just
geography?
Yes.
Is that what I picked?
Oh, yes.
I thought it was the different makes of tires.
No.
I did research a whole week on the different makes of tires.
No, it's...
I got bicycle tires,
geography.
Motorcycle tires.
Here comes our isolation booth now.
This is the booth? Sort of a low-budget show, isn't it?
All right, sir.
There they go!
Thank you. Now, all right, sir. Good. Can you see and hear me?
Huh?
I say, can you see and hear me?
Oh, sure I can see and hear you.
Good. Here is your $64,000 question. This question is in four parts. You must answer all four correctly in order to win. Listen carefully. I will only ask the questions once. One, name all the principal rivers in the United States and their tributaries. Two, name all the geographical points of interest, including national forest, parks, reserves, and man-made wonders. Three, name all the outstanding nightclubs, dives, joints, and saloons. Four, name all the 48 states in 30 seconds. Simple, isn't it?
Yeah. What do you got there on the different makes of tires?
You win one, two, and two easily, would you?
You're darn right I would.
So, here's what we're going to do.
There's more?
Part B.
Part B?
I'm going to have the orchestra play Holiday for Strings. Not only must you answer your questions exactly, but your answers must be sung and fit the musical phrases so that you and the orchestra finish simultaneously. In other words, you're to sing all your answers. You know Holiday for Strings, of course.
No.
Well, that'll make it a little more difficult, eh?
Get your hand out of the booth.
Now, sir, you have 30 seconds in which to decide upon your answer. Your time is up, sir.
Mr. March, can I have a little more time?
How much?
Another week?
No. All right, sir. For $64,000, name all the principal rivers in the United States and their tributaries.
Mississippi, Rio Grande, Hudson, Emmanunga, Heliswani, Wabasha, Potomac, Rappahannock, Chattahoochee, Cumberland, Columbia, Mohawk, and of course, there's the Red River Valley.
You're right, too. Name all the geographical points of interest, including national forests, parks, reserves, and man-made wonders.
Yellowstone, Sequoia, Cosmic Caverns, Hialeah, Painted Desert, Boulder Dam, Niagara Falls, Canyon, Mammoth Cave, Yosemite, the Great Salt Lake, Crosby, Park, and Grove Singers.
You're right, three. Name all the outstanding nightclubs, dives, joints, and saloons.
Shaperville, Villa Martin, Nick, Tacoma, Endo, Carol, Latin, Quarter, Trucker, Horn, a Hardy, Kitty, Davis, Stoklops, Zanzibar, McCombie, Duffy, Starrin, Size, and Bakersfield.
You're right. Four. Name all the 48 states in 30 seconds. Go.
District of Columbia, New Hampshire, Massachusetts, Alabama, South Dakota, North Dakota, Minnesota, Oklahoma, West Virginia, California, Georgia, Texas, Maine.
Good.
Mississippi, Washington, South Carolina, Arkansas, North Carolina, Tennessee, Louisiana, Iowa, Nevada, Kansas, Arizona, Colorado, Michigan.
That's right.
New Jersey, New York, New Mexico, Ohio, Illinois, Missouri, Indiana, and Montana.
10 seconds!
Fans of Maryland, or Wisconsin, Utah, Maryland, Kentucky, Oregon, Rhode Island, Idaho, Nebraska, Vermont, Virginia, Delaware, Wyoming, Connecticut.
You're absolutely right, right there.
You've been listening to Countdown 25, a silver replay of the best of AFN's 25 years on the air. Tonight, AFN has brought you the sounds of its 14th year of broadcasting, the sounds that began emanating from AFN's transmitters on the 4th of July in 1956. Tomorrow evening and each evening at the same time until July 4th, 1968, AFN will present a sound review of the years it has been serving American forces in Europe. A countdown to AFN's silver anniversary.